Hi, Chris with RC Wurst here, and today we're going to be talking about control panels and selecting a basic control panel. And what I want to cover in this video is how you can actually use this information to save money on selecting a control panel and avoid buying any unnecessary components and any unnecessary features. So let's jump right into it. I've got a few control panels as an example and a number of different topics we're going to cover, so stay tuned. All right, so the first thing that we're going to talk about is price. Price is always an important factor when you're selecting a control panel. Obviously, how much you pay or how much you can afford to pay has a big influence over whether or not you make that purchase decision. And a lot of times, there's a lot of manufacturers in the marketplace who are selling substandard products for really aggressive prices, really low prices. The result is a lot of times failures within the system due to poor quality components that are used in those control panels. So price is an important factor, but it's definitely not everything. There's a lot of other factors that you're gonna wanna look at when you're selecting a control panel. It's completely possible and reasonable to expect somebody out there to have a control panel with quality components for an affordable and fair price. So hopefully this guide will help you in that selection process. A common practice in the industry when you're dealing with smaller mom and pop shops, even some of the larger corporations, is using what's known as like a multi-facet or a multi-purpose control panel. So for example, there's a number of control panels on the market that are rated for 120 and 230 volt for residential applications. They're panels that maybe have some extra features built into them, such as redundant off, cycle counters, and various other features that may not pertain to you specifically. So an important thing to keep in mind is when you're shopping for a panel, you want to try to get one that only has the features that you really need so that you're not paying for something that you don't need. And I'll explain a little bit about the dual purpose or multi-purpose panels a little bit more. Is the reason that installers will go the route of having those panels is that they can roll up at almost any job site and have the right panel for the job to get it fixed. Now, the unfortunate thing about that is the consumer oftentimes ends up paying a little bit more money than what they really necessarily needed to, or the convenience to the installer is a cost to the consumer. So keep an eye out for that and be wary of that. So to further illustrate my point on price and panel complexity, I've got three panels behind me here that I've hand selected to kind of showcase this example. So the first panel that we have here, this is an Orenco A-Series panel. And when we look inside, this panel is almost empty. There is almost nothing in this thing. And this panel is specifically designed for on and off applications, an operation of a single pump unit. So this panel is bare bones. It does have an alarm built into it, a light built into it, and it has a control breaker and a pump breaker. And in addition to that, a hand off auto or manual off auto switch. This is gonna be something you wanna look for in any panel that you buy for troubleshooting and testing purposes. The second panel that we have here, this is a CSI control panel. It's a Power Zone Series control panel. This is a little bit more of a basic panel, but what you can see here is this panel does actually have a circuit board, so it does offer some more advanced functionality out of the box. Now, if you were to compare the price of this panel and this panel, you would definitely see somewhat of a price difference, and you would also see that this panel offers quite a number of additional features. A couple of those features include a pump run light, a power light, and then the control power light, and that's gonna indicate if you've got any tripped breakers or anything before you even open the panel. In addition to that, on the circuit board, we've got a number readout. You can get things such as cycle counter from that. So there are some built-in features with these panels that are kinda nice to have, but may not be something you need for your application. And then on the extreme end of the spectrum, I got this large Orenco control panel, and this panel has almost all the bells and whistles. This panel here has a PLC controller, or like a VFD, for a variable frequency operation of the pump. It's got a logic controller in it so that there's some programmability to it. You've got cycle counters, thermal counters, all kinds of different sensors inside of this panel. So if you were an everyday homeowner and somebody comes to you and says, yeah, Mr. Homeowner, you're looking at this $2,000 panel to replace the panel that you have. It's going to give you everything you need plus more. You really got to question that and more portion of that, because you may not need that. So the next thing that we're going to cover is warranty. When you're selecting a control panel, you definitely want to pay attention to what the manufacturer's warranty is, because that speaks a lot about the manufacturer's confidence in the product. As I mentioned before, there's a lot of competition in this marketplace using substandard products, so keeping an eye on that warranty is going to give you a good idea of what kind of a life you can expect and what quality components are contained within the panel. And I will say that from all the panels we have on display here, the industry standard is generally 3 to 5 years. All of these panels fit within that range, and all of these panels, I can tell you, definitely have quality components inside them. So be wary of that. Use that as a good benchmark for deciding one panel over the other if you find yourself torn. Now we're on to the next topic, looking at the voltage and the amperage. These are definitely crucial steps when selecting a control panel. You've got to be aware of what voltage you have on the supply side so that you can determine what your options are in terms of a pump and a control panel. Obviously, your control panel needs to match the voltage of the pump. An important thing to do is decide what pump you're going to run and how the system is going to operate, and then compare the pump motor information, such as voltage and amperage, with the ratings that the panels hold. That way you can determine if it's a good fit or not. Now we're on to the desired control type, where we're focusing on the functionality of the panel. How is the panel going to be signaled to turn the pump off or on? Most commonly, what you're seeing out there is float switches. The float raises, the pump turns on, or something along those lines. But you've also got various other technologies, transducers, pressure bells, you've got probes, pressure switches if you're using a panel on a water situation, such as filling a reservoir or something along those lines. So be aware of how you plan to signal the pump so that you can select a control panel that works well with that type of an interface. The next thing that's really important when you're selecting a control panel is the enclosure rating. Now, all of the panels that we have here today are NEMA 4X rated enclosures. Now, NEMA 4X means the panel's rated for indoor or outdoor use, and it's going to provide some level of protection on the exterior of the panel from anyone getting electrically shocked from the components within the panel. So safety is definitely an important factor, but also the ambient location of the panel. If it's really hot, really humid, or it's indoors, you may not need an outdoor rated panel. So be aware of what enclosure the control panel that you're considering has, and determine if that's going to be a good fit for you. If you'd like to read more about the different enclosure ratings on the market, I recommend you go straight to the source. Go to NEMA.org, and that's where you're going to find all the information about how they test the panels, what the different ratings are, and what those ratings mean. And finally, we're getting into the extra features section of control panels, where you're going to consider what features and functionalities offered within that panel and make a determination of if that's the right panel for you. There's a couple of features that are standard in a lot of panels that I think bring a lot of value to that panel. Some of those would be a alarm light or a red alarm light. We've got a couple of flashers. The Orenco's kind of have a smaller alarm light, which it does have a pretty loud 93 decibel rated alarm. So it's quite loud, and you'll hear it even through a wall. So paying attention to how loud the alarm is, where the light is located relative to whether or not you're gonna see it. Perhaps the panel's facing away from your house or window and you wouldn't see this small beacon. You may opt for a control panel that has a beacon on top of it in those scenarios. So they're definitely out there, and there's plenty of options on the table. There's some other functionality that's really nice. Lockable latches, like what we have on these panels here, that's not a standard feature on every panel in the market. So if you want a lockable latch to keep the kids in the neighborhood out, or you know, just to have that peace of mind that nobody's going to be digging through your control panel without your knowledge, those are important features to look out for. Finally, one feature that I think is a really nice feature is a redundant off. And it's not necessarily a feature that's common across all of the panels out there. There's a lot of areas, counties, cities, and states that require redundant off to be installed anyways, but what a redundant off does is it gives you an extra float in the system on the very bottom that essentially turns everything off. So let's say you have a pump off float fail, and otherwise your pump would sit there and run until it burns up. With a redundant off, the cost of an extra float, you know, $30, $40, you're able to assure yourself that that system's going to shut off and add one extra layer of redundancy and reliability to the system. So that's kind of my top list of baseline features that I would recommend in almost every situation. And the last point that I want to leave you with today is custom control panels are definitely an option to consider. It might surprise you, you know, a lot of times we think of custom like a custom car or a custom kitchen or something along those lines, and that's a lot of money. But in this case, custom control panels can oftentimes be a much more cost-effective way of getting exactly the panel that you need. And in many cases, it only takes 3 to 5 days to get a control panel built and out the door. So if you can afford to wait, then give us a call. We're happy to put together a custom control panel specifically for your application, and there's really not much of a wait. So that's it today. Thanks for joining me on another great RC Wurst video. I hope you learned something, but I got work to do.